Episode 5, What Friends Are For. Mateo stormed into his room and was angrily eating a banana before he was ready to find Mr. Hilbert.
So you finally get it. In this world, it's
shut up.
Oh. You're that way now, huh? Don't be mad, though. I can help you.
How?
I know where Mr. Hilbert's going to attack.
Where?
Hilbert's going to attack Wilcox tomorrow.
Thanks for the information.
You're welcome. I'll be waiting.
Caddy went out the window. Suddenly, Mateo had a realization. You were right, Matthew. All this time, I had been angry. For nothing. I'm really sorry for the self-hate. That's okay.
You can say that again.
Mateo's friends came into his room.
We all forgive you for what you did.
No matter how many times we regret the incident, we're going to catch Hilbert, and this time we'll do it right.
Please don't leave us on a spooky lab, on a scary lab next time.
Mateo, we found something else in the recording. Mateo learned that Mr. Hilbert was upset at Mr. Michael after the incident and blamed him for the presumed loss of one of his sons.
No wonder he's so cranky.
Where is he now?
I know where he'll be. The next day, Mr. Michael was hosting a meeting in Wilcox. Suddenly, Mr. Hilbert appeared and took him hostage. Everyone fled the scene.
Was my son a setback?
Hey, old sport. Call me old sport. One more time!
He said he was about to blast him.
Sorry if I butchered that.
All right, then. Your son. That was an accident.
No! You knew it was unsafe. My son is gone because of your arrogance.
Dozens of power hands were carrying pieces of the portal to G4M3-F1L3S.
You took everything from me when Andrew went in there, even by accident. Now I'm taking everything from you.
You know the school, it's not just ours, it's everyone's school. So you're basically taking your own room.
Oh, I should have thought that through.
The portal activated and started sucking everything in sight. Mr. Hilbert! Mateo and friends came to the scene.
Let him go. Is this what Andrew would have wanted?
Andrew is gone!
This won't change anything. Trust me, I know. Hilbert used Red Pulse on our heroes, and they all dodged just in time. Mateo and friends were ready to attack. After he swung his hammer and missed, Mateo was being pulled toward the portal. All his other friends were fighting him one by one. Hilbert managed to trap every single one of them.
Oh no! He's meeting all my standards!
I'm scared.
We can't beat him. He's too strong.
We're done for. Mateo, can you hear us?
Are you listening?
Answer us!
As he saw some power hands get sucked into the portal, Mateo had an idea.
That's it.
Listen up, everyone. Use your heads and think of solutions, and then we'll group up. His friends all listened. Mateo, seeing the result, was filled with hope and determination, and he had the ability to fly thanks to his combined hope and determination. Our heroes regrouped up and came up with a new plan. Attack the power hands. Things were all going to plan. When Mr. Hilbert caught Mateo, he was about to blast him.
This ends now!
Nothing happened. He tried again. Nothing happened. And again, nothing happened.
Looks like you're out of power hands.
You're finished!
Mateo broke free and faked his attack. You're finished with your supposed reign of terror. We're on a route where no killing is necessary. But I'll take that. He took Mr. Hilbert's mask and the transmitter and smashed it, causing all the remaining power hands to deactivate and fall along with the portal. After the fight, the portal was still on. It couldn't be turned off and would explode at any minute. Mateo sensed, as they were going to run away, he sensed that someone was still alive in there. He went inside to find Andrew, Hilbert's son. Mateo was in a dark void, covered in debris the portal sucked up. Matthew was there to keep him company. In the distance, there was a girl struggling to clean up the mess. Mateo wanted to talk to her. Hello, excuse me, can you help me?
Huh? Mateo? You're here?
Yeah. How do you know my name?
Because you look like one of my two creators.
Right. Creators?
Yeah. Unlike your friends, I am not based off a real person. I was created by much larger humans that had more realistic, like, features and stuff.
What's your name?
My name is Penn. It's my duty to maintain the game files of Mateo and Friends, the 2019 reboot.
Cool. Do you know where Andrew is?
Sure, follow me.
Mateo followed Penn to a room of bubbled souls as she brought Andrew's down from the ceiling.
Now, in exchange for Andrew's soul, I'll need someone else's to fill in the gap.
Wait, what? Don't worry, I'll do it.
No, don't do it!
Caddy, you followed us here?
Yeah.
Caddy and Penn were the only ones, along with Mateo, who could see Matthew and his ghost.
Matthew, please don't go!
I have to, Caddy. It's the only way to keep the universe balanced and not cause glitches to appear.
Okay. Goodbye, Matthew.
We'll both miss you. So long, Mateo and Caddy. I'll always be with you. Stay determined.
Why, that was stupendous
information and advice. Is that why you're called Penn?
Yeah. Stupendous, isn't it?
Right. Matthew then turned into a heart, a red heart, and Penn bubbled it.
Thanks for the soul. Here's Andrew's. Thanks.
We gotta go.
Bye, Penn. Take care.
Mateo and Caddy raced out of the game files just in time before the portal exploded.
That was close. Too close.
Mateo, everyone shouted as they ran toward him. They were all proud of him after saving Andrew. Shortly after, Mr. Hilbert was arrested, but don't worry, we'll see him again sometime. And Andrew was taken to a hospital. On September 30th, it was Chris's birthday. The party was being held at the bowling alley's Mateo. Mateo apologized to Brianna that the portal hands had been destroyed and missing. She forgave him and said that she'll remake them. Everyone had a blast on their first adventure. Mateo's friends would always be by his side, ready for anything. Because that's what friends are for. Next time, a new beginning.